Hi, and welcome to episode 2 of Candid Conversations. For my first episode, I interviewed my younger sister, but for this episode, I thought, who better than to have a conversation with than myself, or I guess whoever's watching? Mostly because everyone I asked to interview was busy, so here we are with this idea. I thought it would be interesting to show how much my life has changed from a day-to-day basis since the pandemic. Honestly, most of my days are the exact same and honestly have lumped together at this point, but along the way I have developed some healthy habits and practices that I probably wouldn't have if it weren't for the pandemic. So I thought it would be interesting to talk about and show what a typical day in my pandemic life looks like. So yeah, those clips just kind of showed the different practices and habits that I've picked up over the course of the pandemic. I left a few things out, but honestly, the one thing that I'm trying to do is just learn to live day by day in the moment. So most of the stuff that I didn't film, like having dinner every night with my family, having movie nights, and like FaceTiming with friends and me time, but those are some practices that I've developed. So first in the video, I usually wake up every morning around 7:30, mostly because that's the time my parents leave for work. So by default, I just kind of hear them and wake up, but that's something I never used to do. I used to try and sleep in as much as possible and start my day kind of later, but waking up early has kind of forced me to make sure that my day is what I want it to be. So usually I wake up around 7 and go for an early morning walk. I find that that's the most relaxing for me and the most time that I get to spend with myself kind of alone in nature. Honestly, before the pandemic, I really didn't appreciate being outside and going on walks and stuff. So that's something that I've really learned to appreciate and learned to incorporate in my everyday life. So next, I meditate every single day after I spend time outside. To others, it might seem really tedious, and that's what I thought at first, but once I learned the practices of meditation and spirituality, I really found that it's helped me stay grounded and really be thankful for everything that I have and all the experiences that I'm able to still have. So usually every time that I go for a walk or spend any time out in nature, I try and meditate for at least 10 minutes. And usually it's for more, but it's the one thing that I really look forward to in my morning is just coming back from my walk and just sitting with all the sounds and sights. So meditating is something that I'm really glad that I took up and learned about for myself, which I'm still learning to do, but yeah, I highly recommend taking time out of your day to be thankful and just spend time with yourself in silence. So next, after meditating, I usually grab my green tea. I'm not a coffee drinker, so tea's kind of my thing. It's my vice. So I usually grab a tea and eat breakfast. I always used to skip out on breakfast, but now I've just kind of realized that eating first thing in the morning and having a good strong meal helps me throughout my day, especially with doing online classes and being on my computer all day. It kind of helps me start off the day mentally strong, physically strong, and full. And yeah, it just makes me feel good to have breakfast. I love breakfast. So after eating breakfast, of course, that's usually around the time that I attend classes. So obviously online classes is way different from in-person classes, but I try and make sure that I get ready for the day and am present in class. I try to have my camera on as much as I can because it makes me feel more present and active in my learning. So yeah, and then usually in the afternoons after class, I go help out at my parents' store. My parents own a butcher shop, and I used to never really go and visit or help out. I wasn't really involved in the family business at all because I had a job of my own. I used to serve at a restaurant, but of course, because of COVID, the restaurant I worked at closed down. So I'm really fortunate that my family has this business, and I'm really lucky that kind of gives me an opportunity to see what my parents go through firsthand, and also gives me an excuse to get out sometimes. So I'm really lucky that I have a job of some sort. So next, here are some things that I showed clips of and wanted to talk a little bit more about. Ever since the pandemic started, I've read so much more. I've always been a big reader, but my life was always just really fast paced. I was a full-time student, I was a full-time worker, so I never really had time to read, or I would just make up excuses why I couldn't read. So reading is one of the things I'm really glad that I've picked back up again. I've read at least 4 or 5 books within the span of the pandemic, which might not seem like a lot, but for me, it's probably more than I would have read in a year. So also, I've learned to spend time alone with myself and just be really happy with my present self. So in the video, I showed a clip of me dancing alone in my room, and it's not something that I do every day, but it's something that I really find important for my mental health and for my safe space. So a lot of times I just dance alone in my room, and it just kind of makes me feel good. It kind of lifts my mood up a little bit, gives me a little bit of serotonin. So yeah, that's something that I do, not every day, but often. And then journaling. Journaling has become a huge part of my life during the pandemic. Here's my journal, my personalized journal. I try and journal every day, if not usually when I just kind of get the urge to journal. And I filled up the majority of these pages with just art and my feelings throughout the pandemic. And I don't know, it's nice to look back at now and see how different things are and how my feelings have developed since then. So I highly, highly recommend journaling. I'm so glad that it's something that I picked up. I love writing, and it also helps me be more in touch with myself and my feelings, which I'm really grateful for. So I love my trusty journal. And then last but not least, something that I didn't show was spending time with my family. We try and have dinner every single night, which is something we never used to do before. I know that this pandemic has really brought us together, and we incorporate as much family time as we can, whether it's having dinner together at the dinner table, watching a movie, or just spending time together at work. So those are just some of the habits and practices that I've developed during the pandemic. Thanks for watching.